Hello, good evening. Yeah, welcome to the last track of tutorial day. Now I will try to explain how we can create the desktop application, or yeah, we can create desktop GUI with PHP. So I will introduction to myself. My name is Yuri. Now I was a Malang PHP user group organizer, and yeah, my daily work is currently now I remote worker and sometimes I freelance. Mostly I do in back end program, but often I also code on in the front, so I can speak in the front end language. But several years ago, I interest in UI and UX, but in all about pixel perfectionist. So, yeah, so I can do all the thing from front to back. You can find me more at yourpertamax.me. Okay, let me start. Oh yeah, we have some agenda or plan. The first is requirement is simple. The requirement only, yeah, I will tell it later, disclaimer, until we can do some code. Maybe you can follow me to code and you can try how can we create a desktop application with PHP. Yeah, the requirements I already tell in the Slack group in welcome room. Yeah, we need PHP version 5.3 or above. And second, we must have Git, because we need to clone the repo. It's from my repo or the another people repo. And then we need to have Composer in our laptop. And you have Composer? Already have?
I don't.
Yeah, maybe which can be installed the Composer in each laptop. And the fourth is favorite text editor, maybe Sublime or yeah, it's up to you. And then make sure your PHP can be executed from CLI, because we execute the program from CLI, not from browser. And then internet connection to make sure Composer install and Git clone works well. Yeah, because my topic is very cross-platform is sensitive, and there are so many issues with my topic, so I make great, yeah, tell the disclaimer in my presentation. Yeah, the first, I didn't invent the technologies, so all the libraries, tools or plugin that I will tell you about my experience is not mine, so I just tried to use and combine it so we can make the desktop apps with PHP. Yeah, the serious one is I'm very sorry for Windows user, because some cross-platform issue, but you can always use VirtualBox or VMware to install Ubuntu. Yeah, I'm sorry before, but later I will tell how we can create them in Windows OS. Yeah, I'm sorry. So for this time, Linux or Unix platform more preferable. Yeah, I hope the people who have only Windows OS can install the another OS via VMware or VirtualBox, or yeah, can only watch. Okay. Yeah, this disclaimer. Ah, the last one is only the basic usage that I will present. The rest will be explored by ourselves because the API or the function is very large, and we can't use or try it one-to-one. Okay. Yeah, how can we create desktop apps? Anyone here before PHP can be created for desktop apps?
Yeah.
Long time. What tools do you use, or what do you hear?
There was PHP GTK.
GTK, yeah, GTK is very long. I hear about 2010. What year? Last time?
Yeah. 2000.
Yeah, it's very, very.
GTK with PHP 3 is really.
Old school. Old school programmer should know about PHP GTK. Anyone else? Who experience with desktop apps with PHP or desktop GUI? Or no?
I've read something before, but never attempted to do anything.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. The popular one is PHP GTK, and the last development I hear is PHP GTK 2. Which is support PHP 5.5. Yes, still not dead, but it's very old school. Yeah. Actually, many tools, many platform can support. How can we port PHP program to desktop apps? But yeah, some of them not sustainable. And that. There is some tool. There is many tools that can desktopize PHP. As Mr. Who? What's your name?
Damien.
Yeah, Damien. Tell GTK or PHP GTK. GTK is GUI. In the next slide, I will tell about the details. And the second one is PHP Nitrine. Nitrine is very good tools, very good framework, but last year he is dead. But I still have the source code from them. And the third is VXPHP. It run over VX widget, who popular from make GUI. And then there are Tight SDK or Titanium. Anyone here before? No. Yeah.
I use something called Titanium for mobile development.
Yeah.
Is it the same or something?
Same Titanium, but for porting the PHP development is called Tight SDK and now unmaintainable. Okay. And yeah, I just explore. There is the name of PHP Qt, which run over Qt framework. Okay. You should you ever heard the Qt? Qt. And then the last one, PHP desktop and WinBinder or WebBinder is Windows only. So the Windows user, I recommend the last two one because the cross platform issue, I don't cover the Windows OS. Okay, there are 7 tools that can desktopize PHP. Yeah, but some the 7 of tools in the front, I don't use them. Later, I will tell you what my choice for create PHP desktop apps. Yeah, this is some details information for GDK. GDK is cross-platform, so it is very old-school, old-fashioned. But GDK is cross-language, so GDK is can bind for another language such as PHP, Python, and another else. So it cross-platform and cross-language. For PHP programming, there are PHP GDK that implements language binding for GDK Plus. Yeah, GDK Plus is a GUI toolkit, so PHP GDK is for building desktop GUI application. Nah, the last one, latest version of PHP GDK is PHP GDK 2 with minimum requirement for PHP 55.
Minimum.
But I never hear about the development again for PHP GDK, so I don't use the GDK for this tutorial. But GDK is very popular, right? Many programmer ever hear these tools. Yeah, the second one, this is my favorite ever, but my last use about 2 years ago. And now the repo and the everything about it is, yeah, is dead. But it has cross-platform, and I claim the PHP NetRen is easiest and the best tool ever because I don't have to any effort to create and compile them to porting the PHP into cross-platform desktop apps. But the dependency is Python, Python installer, and VX Python. Yeah, some of point PHP 5 precompile, so we can use our PHP version to these apps. So we can use my choice of PHP version, and then GUI rendering for PHP or HTML web application. Can set custom weight and yeah, many and the other, but that and this cause discontinue. Yeah, and then VX PHP. Actually. It only binding or wrapper for cross-platform library VX widget. So VX widget has binding for PHP called VX PHP. But it always use native GUI and still under active development. Yeah, that SDK need SDK to develop. PHP desktop is Windows only. WinBinder is Windows only. Yeah, why we use PHP to create desktop apps? Anyone can answer. What is the pros and cons about desktop apps for generally or? Yeah. Yeah, maybe someone can answer. What problem for desktop app for generally or PHP for desktop apps? Anyone?
Pretty much all the API in PHP is for server-side handling.
Oh yeah.
So only it can like using PHP for desktop application, you will use the syntax, but none of the components apply to desktop application development. So all the components that you use are again different. You need to definitely learn them. So that can be the disadvantage.
Okay. Anyone else?
Advantage will be the familiar syntax.
Yeah, okay. Anyone else?
Trouble when we update the version.
Oh, yeah.
If we computer, we must set up the configuration as well.
Okay. Anyone ever hear Electron?
It's called JavaScript.
Yeah. Why? Electron is very popular and the better tools to create desktop apps for HTML or JavaScript apps, maybe? Why?
I don't think it's that popular.
Oh, yeah.
Still a lot of people
there's
use
people
Electron.
Using it, but most of them are moving towards web apps.
Or just because the JavaScript is has ability to asynchron, yeah, but the PHP can do it, or other reason why Electron is very popular and yeah, this can be make powerful desktop apps just from JavaScript, yeah, right?
Electron is popular because of Atom. Many people looked at Atom and then see how they developed it.
Because
if it is easy, yeah, I can also develop something with JavaScript.
Just because
that's
Atom.
How people looked at Electron.
Oh, okay. Yeah, actually I inspired by Electron and Corona. Until now I still
I think you have some Facebook or something.
Yeah. Yeah, and until now I still when the PHP language can be powerful to porting to desktop apps like Electron, and I explored to the Google, and there are some pros and cons about the desktop apps which is built from PHP. The pros one, actually, if we don't type in the browser like localhost blah 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 blah, I think it will be sexy because we have application which is bundled and yeah, clickable application, not via localhost by browser, by AMP, Apache MySQL, and something like that.
So is it like wrapping your HTML application written in PHP with the browser and packaging it as a native application?
Yeah, maybe, but still need web server, still need databases and some of others. So it can be individual bundled by its language. So yeah. Second one is application is loaded on its own native window because the GUI is the native window, so application is not loaded to the browser, but it loaded in its own native window. The third is no need to install a web server, and our PHP application desktop will run on Windows, Linux, and Mac. Actually,
To clarify, you cannot develop on Windows, but
yeah.
Once you compile, you can run it on Windows as
yeah.
Well.
Yeah, these are just claim for pros. Yeah, maybe some libraries, framework, or plugins with PHP base need GUI to control. So, maybe some libraries or some framework often need GUI to control that, so the end user will be easy to control. Yeah, and then people are not always online, so yeah, some application would be have some bandwidth problem. some data is too sensitive to be passed on the wire. So this why desktop apps can be choice of now this application. Yeah, embedded OSs don't always work well with websites. Yeah, browser are just just quirky like Internet Explorer or Opera, and desktop rich internet application tools still young. But there are any cons for PHP. Actually, PHP is designed for web, not for desktop environment. Agree with this statement? Yeah. Actually very bad and worse idea if we porting and or wrap full regular PHP application. So we have a full PHP application, we port it all or wrap it all into the desktop GUI with its web server, PHP binary and databases. So it's very very bad idea, because that later I will tell you I just cover how we can use the PHP language, pure PHP language for GUI, not web server, not PHP binary, not databases. Yeah, in fact, seven tools that I tell to you last slide ago is some of them only wrap the web app as web view. So if we have application web application such as Laravel or Symfony with its design GUI from HTML or CSS, some of them like PHP Nitrine is only wrap it into the GUI, but it can control the native GUI. Yeah, when it said GUI framework, we will expect it a way to make cross-platform apps, and it must have native UI control, such as the menu, such as the button, not as a web view with embedded PHP executable. So I already tell you many platform or framework are abandoned or outdated, some of them dead and unmaintained. I don't know why. Maybe this regular slide one, advantages of using PHP is no compiling, instant changes, easy to use, fast to write, and already used with familiar libraries and tools. So we need solution about it. Who want to create desktop apps or at least desktop GUI, minimum the dialog one or the text area one for the native GUI framework or window or design. Yeah, I have a solution for Mac OS or OS X. I found a good library or good framework called Pasua. And for Linux and Unix, I will use the Zenity to create the PHP desktop application. Actually, the Zenity is support in the OS X, since the OS X based on Unix platform. But the Windows, sorry before, Zenity already developed for Windows, but that's still long year ago. But I don't try it in the Windows. But the PHP GTK, I think, will work well in Windows. But I will cover for the tutorial only the two point for Mac OS is Pasua, and the Linux or Unix is Zenity.
So Zenity applications won't run directly on Mac, is it?
It's same. The Zenity can be installed via Homebrew.
Okay.
Yeah, I will.
If I want to develop a Mac application,
yeah,
I can do it with Zenity and run it, or I need to use a different one, like Pasua.
If we want to bundle in the application, or what?
So, like, I want to develop OS X. So Zenity covers OS X as well, right?
Yeah.
So if you want just pure OS X, nothing else, then you can go for Pasua.
Yeah.
Am I correct?
Yeah, like this. But the Zenity one is the GUI not so native for Mac OS, but still good to choice. Yeah, maybe this one can be followed by Mac OS user. Yeah, maybe. The Pasua has website. You can visit them. Oh. Yep. www.bluem.net/n/mac/pasua. And then the Pasua has PHP binding, which is addressed in github.com/bluem/pasua/binding PHP. I tried to find it in Composer, but I can't find one. So we can download the the library from it websites. Yeah, download. Actually, the one is core app for we can have development in OS X. Okay. Yeah, but the core app is .dmg.app. So it's very weird, but yeah, it works. So you can download the core app and place it on your application folder. And I have repository that I create for PHP binding. Actually, Pasua PHP binding is not created by me, but my repo is edited for this tutorial purpose only. So maybe we can do it now. We can download it from from the websites, and then make sure you have the Pasua is on your application folders. If the Pasua is already in application folder, is all people here? The laptop is installed by Git already. Git in the laptop.
Yeah. Should be there pretty much on all the.
Yeah. So you can clone my repository into the folders. Yeah. Okay, we can create new folder for our source code. Let's call PHP desktop. And we can clone from my repository. Yeah, there is only two PHP files that very important. The first one is password.php and the second one is example.php. The another one readme is not need by script, and I place the PHP conf asia logo.png for example. So if we already have Pasua in our application folder, so we can execute the script before I open it for editing the source. I tried it. Yeah. After we execute it, there is desktop GUI with Pasua. Maybe we can open it in our editor. Yeah, if you confused by the code, we can create the another one, the clean one, so we don't need to follow this code. So we create the new one. Yeah, we can create the new one of application. Let's call Pasua example, and we can enter the directory and open it in Sublime. Yeah, this very clean folder. At first, we need to create the maybe index.php, and then we have to include the PHP path before we can use the PHP to communicate with Fuzz Pasua, and then we have to require the password.php. The password.php is provided by the my repository, so we should copy it into the our folder project. Yeah, this password.php we copy it into the new one, and we require it to the script. Yeah, maybe the minimum version is not necessary, but it must be tell the minimum version is 5.3. Okay, next we can add some script to Windows title. We we can create the variable. The name is maybe text or title. Yeah, text. Maybe text. Maybe we can set the title "Welcome to PHP Conference Asia 2016." Yeah, we need to use EOConf to start and end the line, and we just can load the password.app from here. Yeah.
So I don't think that EOConf, that name is important.
Yeah, very important.
It can be anything. You have to edit with the same.
Yeah, but if we deleted the EOConf,
then you just delete later on both the sides, like on the start, on the end.
Yeah.
If you delete the F, it will still work.
Maybe we can try it. Yeah.
That's later.
Yeah.
That is just PHP way of creating some string. That's all.
Maybe we can try to the string regular string one.
Yeah.
Yeah. And the custom location variable is must be filled by path to password app that we download before to the password.app in the application folder. Maybe the volumes password or volumes password / password.app. Yeah, maybe custom location is can be application / yeah, maybe something like that. Yeah, this one is below if we mount the DMG, but if we create if we copy the password up into the application folder, we can call it something like that, apta / application / password.app. Okay. If it done, so we can use the password function. It calls show dialog, and we can pass the parameter from text variable and custom location variable to the show dialog, and we can see the result. Yeah, PHP. Yeah, this still error. I will try to. Yeah, because if it has no EAConf, EOConf is still error.
You try that first, then we can do the test.
Yeah. Maybe. Oh, I think I forgot the. Yeah, require. Icon pet. Okay.
Here we don't have any image, so we don't need that, right?
Yeah, well, we don't have any. The example that we create is not contain any elements, so we can create the at least one element.
Some button or some label.
Some text, like yeah, some text. Yeah, like, we can create the simple text. which is maybe that like this. So we can create another name for TXT, not strict for TXT name, but TXT is free for use. We can use another like text or variable one, because this name is will be used like if we have HTML form field, but we use the TXT for the default. Okay, hello world. Maybe the default text is hello world. Yeah, the first our hello world desktop apps
okay,
is created.
Now we can test that theory.
Yeah,
of converting that into.
Maybe hello hello from PHP Conference Asia 2016. Yeah, this just one dialogue. You can try it because it need minimum one elements like text or input text or button. For this example is we only create one element called TXT. You can try it. Already try? Yeah, the interesting things that okay. I will tell the secret. Yeah. We can create the feedback from code to be printed in CLI. So we have to print, yeah, something like that. Hello from CLI, and every element creation by Pasua is always give the result that from the elements. So we can try it again. Oh, okay. Yeah, we can see, but we can see in the CLI is feedback from the code. Print hello from CLI is, yeah, this will be needed if we want to make the feedback dialogue or make another dialogue or GUI. Every we give the action for the button or another. Yeah, maybe you can try it for the default one is only view or only show the dialogue. Success. Yeah, this script, maybe you can follow it.
You want to try the string again?
Yeah.
Instead of the...
In the below of...
Yeah, instead of the conf, UO conf.
Oh.
You can just make it a string and it should still work.
Like this?
No. I mean, the above one.
Huh?
Line number six.
The first one,
six.
Line 6.
Line 6.
Yeah, remove the.
Oh.
Just make it a string.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's see if it works.
Yeah, it's still.
It's just plain straight.
Yeah, because this need for the new line. Yeah, so we can split the component or the elements. The title is create for the text variable, and then the another is append to text variable. So our code is easy to read.
Okay. So from my understanding so far,
yeah,
it looks like it has its own scripting language, and we are constructing that kind of script using our PHP skills.
Yeah.
And then pass that script to that, and that is what we see. It's like a long way of touching your nose, right?
Yeah. Yeah, we can use the PHP manipulation for this app.
Yeah, we can construct the script.
Yeah.
We can put whatever we want in there, but then ultimately we are constructing some script that is passed to another application, and that constructs the thing.
Yeah, maybe we can use if else to redirect to another dialogue. Maybe this one is maybe event PHP conference Asia. We can, yes, like always, we can replace it with variable. Yeah. So we still use the regular PHP language, but we can bind it to GUI component. But we still need definition for the desktop or GUI component, like type, default, height, white, width, or another else. Okay, if you have been successful for show the dialogue, we can move to the next step. Maybe the sound. Yeah. Yeah, okay. Our GUI application or desktop application is not only show the text, but we can show the input text, we can show the radio button, we can show the select option drop down element, and we can also create the button element. Okay, let me you can follow me. Yeah, this one is for you can view in the documentation. There are so many API to follow. There are element type button, cancel button, checkbox, combo box, date, default button, image, and yeah, and some regular UI, regular component is provided by Pasua. Maybe we can try to another one. The text variable is append by OK button. Maybe default button. Yeah, example. We can copy the example and create them and pass them to the code. The default the type is default button, and the label is maybe OK, or click here to OK or proceed. We can, yeah, we can have a button to our desktop apps. The interesting things is you can show this. You can see this. We have array from the code, after the button is clicked, it calls DB and the value is 1. Because we have name the default button is DB. Maybe we can call it another name, button 1. And then the second one is button 1. If we click the button 1, we have array from the code, from the action we click the button. Yeah, so we can have some manipulation to our desktop apps. Just use the feedback from button or from action in the form of the GUI. Maybe we can doing something like this. Yeah, if result the array is button 1 is equal to 1, we can create another dialog with another variable. Maybe we can call text2. The text2 is have content almost same, but we have to different them. Maybe something like that. We have titled it confirmation, and then we have to append another component to text2. Yeah, maybe the text. We don't have to define the height with x and y, but we just to try it. You press OK. Nah, since we click here to proceed, we have you press OK. So we can use the PHP language to manipulate the dialog or the GUI component. Yeah, we can free to use. Maybe if button 1 equal 1, we can show the another dialog or another text area. Yeah, something like that. If we want to create results, we have to print like this. This hello from CLI. This result 1. This might be result 2. We just click the output the result 2. If the component have no input component, the result have nothing to display like this. If we click here and hello from CLI. The result 1. I forgot. The terminal is should nothing because we don't have any component that have input text or action component. Like if in the HTML we have text input type text or input type button, input type radio button or input type checkbox or select option, yeah, something like that, is needed by GUI to return the value to CLI. Yeah, any question before I start, I continue to another example.
So, can it communicate with the web server, this desktop application?
Maybe this just pure PHP language, not web server. But if we want to communicate with web server or databases, I think this one is can be included in here. For example, MySQL Connect. Or something like that. I think this is possible.
Not local server, remote web server. I mean, to some API. Can it call some API and show?
You can do a code.
Yeah, similar to how we used to communicate from one server to another. Right?
Yeah.
You have to pull some data from another server. You use curl or some HTTP client library, right? So you use that to call.
Okay.
That you can always
do. Oh, yeah. Yeah, maybe I never use for it. Maybe PHP, some IP, or something like that.
Mm.
Or yeah, I never use it for it. But I think we can use the another option like databases or.
No, I was just wondering one use case is like this. We have one website. Our staff have to update something on that website. We can do a admin page or dashboard page to do that, so that they can upload the data. But that means I'm making it available to public. We can restrict it with username, password, etc. But still, I don't want to want the public to see that page. Dashboard. Instead, can I create a desktop application and upload the data to the server?
Still, you have the same thing, right? So here, the problem is the script is also lives with the person, like whoever you are giving it to.
Hmm.
If they can go and see the script, they know exactly how you call that, and they can call it themselves. Yeah, it is one layer of protection, but then still everything is in plain text there.
Hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
But that is possible from database application to server is possible.
Yeah, yeah.
You would want to implement an API on the server side and then use OAuth or whatever or JWT to implement your authentication.
Yeah.
Okay. Any question? Another? Anyone else?
Okay.
Or
so here, I want to display a dialog box. Ask them something like, are you above 18 or not? And then based on that, I want to display some content.
Okay. Oh.
So actually, the PHP is paused at that time, is when the dialog box comes in. And when I answer only, then it proceeds, is it? I'm just trying to understand the technology here.
Oh. Yeah, maybe we can try to create some another example to show how interaction with the input input action like maybe we can swipe off the text variable and make the another in Paswa it has many API such as we can have the text. Yeah, the text is very important to us to pass the parameter, pass the variable or pass the value to another page, another content. Yeah, maybe the text. I'm sorry, the text box. Yeah. Text box or text field. Nah. I'm sorry, the text one is the I example before. Yeah, the text field is very important. We can try to make it and show the to the GUI. maybe tests. The default maybe it's something like this should be placeholder. The tooltip is if hover it for few seconds. Yeah, maybe we can.
No, I want to process that input and then start another screen or something.
Okay. Yeah, maybe. If this maybe too small, maybe I can use the built-in. This better. Okay. Yeah. This example for input text, we can enter it any string, maybe our name, John Doe. Okay, so this for default, by default it close and does have no action. I will try to create the action for the text box. Yeah, maybe we can name it, maybe name for the variable name, and then your name. Maybe default we don't need name, tooltip we don't need the tooltip. We can run it again. Yeah. Okay. We need to catch the result from the show dialog. The first show dialog, we catch the result. Maybe we can check it in the CLI if we put my name here. We can check in the CLI. Name is Yuri Pratama. My name.
So it does pass the execution.
Yeah.
At that point.
Nah.
Until they click on a button, they take some action.
Yeah. The default. The another one. I will create in below of the show dialog one. Maybe
we don't have to do that. Like the only test that is needed is this.
Okay.
Whether I'm passing the execution until they take some action, yeah. That seems to happen.
Yeah.
If that happens, I can show another dialogue, yeah, saying that hello, so and so.
Yeah, maybe like this. This result name, result name. So we can pass the name here. Okay. What is who is your name? John. Oh, I just forgot to create a dialogue for the text too. Yeah, something like that. Who is your name? Is John Doe. Element name has none of the attributes default. Maybe name type. Oh, name default. I just forgot. Who's your name? My name is Yuri. Welcome. Something like that.
Okay.
If we can, if we want to passing the parameter to the another dialog, or we need to view the another dialog after the last action, we can do it.
So probably we can execute something in the background when something happens in the server. It'll like keep on pinging the server.
Yeah.
Are you alive? Are you alive? and when it doesn't get a response, it will just scream like the server is down.
Yeah. Yeah, it's because it. I tell my tutorial is not creating the full PHP application from HTML, CSS, and porting it, wrap it to the desktop GUI. But we use the PHP technologies, PHP language, to create the desktop interaction GUI. Maybe you can understand it because it's very different web view and the native GUI is very different. Yeah, you can always try another API. There are still many other component to try because if we don't try it, we don't know how it works. So the rest, I hope you can try it for yourself. The default action, already I tell you. Okay.
Parshva is only user interface, right? If you want to do any logic behind it, for example, writing to a text file or something.
That you can do it in PHP itself, right? Whatever you used to do, you can do. You can make DB calls. Anything you do in PHP, you're still able to do.
Okay.
If you need a Mac UI on top of it, for that you can use that.
Not just the user interface, but the logic is can be provided in file. I think the code is very crappy because it's very procedural, but sometimes I will try to manage them to easiest to read.
If you want, we can write an object oriented wrapper
for
this, which when you call something like new window, it will inside write the same strings that we manually write now.
Okay. Hey, maybe you can
That way you can make it like more object oriented and
maybe you can use OOP or another method to manage the code, so the code is not very procedural from top to from above to bottom. But it's still very bad.
So, they support Perl also, right? Similar to this. So you can do it in Perl again, construct the string and pass it to it.
Okay.
But what is the best language for desktop application development? PHP is for web development, right?
Yeah.
So if you want to do
every platform has
desktop
C kind of language for that.
Maybe C or Python is I think the good one for desktop.
If you want to do cross platform, then Java used to be the first one.
Okay.
Yeah, Sublime Text is built from Python, right? I think it's very fast. I think to compare the Sublime and Atom, is still Sublime is faster.
Then
begin,
why do you need to create a desktop application?
Sorry, I didn't get you.
Why do you need to create desktop application use the PHP? Is it about the server itself? Because the PHP 5.6 have the server installed. You can use something like Laravel, PHP Artisan Serve, and it can run.
There is an option, but still you need a browser too.
Yeah.
And one option to create a desktop application is to just wrap the server, everything inside an executable. So when you run that executable, it will run in some port, and it will open a native window, which is a browser window. Internally, it loads that URL. So it will look like a native application. It don't have any browser screen where you type the URL, but it is a web page that is being rendered on top of it.
How do you make it like when you click on an icon, this window appears?
Maybe
desktop icon.
Just create a shell script.
Executable application. I will provide it in later.
Okay.
Yeah. This maybe the interesting because this one is have to bundling into clickable app. I will cover it later. From Pashua, anyone? Any question? Maybe.
No, I think we have seen enough.
Yeah. Maybe we can
see the next one.
Okay, yeah, just the first the Pashua is very especially for OS X. Yeah, it's a tool for creating native Aqua dialog windows. So this exclusive for OS X, not for another platform. We had to the another one is called Zenity. Zenity is tools or tools or library that can create GUI for GUI framework, but Zenity has binding for PHP. Maybe you can install it for Mac OS, can install the Zenity from Brew, install Zenity, and the Linux or Unix, you can always check with apt get install Zenity. But actually, in the Linux, Zenity is by default, so we don't have any install. Okay. If maybe I will try to demo it into the Linux. Yeah, make sure your OS have Zenity. If your Mac, if you are in Mac OS, you can install it via Homebrew. Yeah, Zenity. By default, Zenity is default by the OS, especially in Ubuntu. But make sure you can type in the terminal and view the Zenity min help to view the option. Okay. If anything okay, I will try to make new project. We open tab. Zenity try. Yeah, we start with empty folders. Maybe you can use the Zenity with option maybe click calendar. Automatic appear the calendar dialog. But we use the Zenity so the Zenity can be support the PHP language. We have to clone. There is some library in available in packages named PHP Zenity React. PHP Zenity React is a PHP binding to build GUI graphical desktop application for PHP. Yeah. Maybe you can in your empty folder. Yeah, because in packages PHP Zenity. Yeah, this. We can require in the composer. Maybe we can start the project with composer in it. Already have composer in TOS. Maybe you can install the composer from getcomposer.org. Who are still not have composer in the laptops? Okay. Yeah, Windows only also support for composer. Okay, so we can continue or okay, yeah. Yeah, maybe we can.
Even if he does that, he cannot develop in Windows.
Right? Yeah. Yeah, I'm sorry before. Yeah, maybe we can start our project with composer in it. Yeah, brutally enter. Oh. Maybe, yeah, I always start the PHP project with composer in it. Maybe we can empty it. So we have composer.json inside of our folder project. And then we require the Zenity. I forgot the name. Glue Zenity React. Yeah, this one is PHP libraries for binding to the Zenity React. After we require the JSON library, we will write. We wait it until it installed in my or in our project folder. Oh, this should. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, we should have vendor folder like always. We install via composer.json, and then we requires composer for instant use. You can visit my repository for using Zenity for PHP. This one you can only clone it and install it via composer, or maybe you can follow my my way. Yeah, we can create then the first file dialog.php. Yeah, the first step we do is we need to write the PHP tags. Oh, where is my repository? very bad. Yeah, maybe I will continue it in Mac OS or we can use some library from Zenity React. Maybe we just use info dialog, so we don't have any another. Maybe a nah. Yeah, the next step is we must require our composer in my project. Maybe we have to require the autoload.php. Yeah, after this, we can create factory, create, yeah, just create it, and then we have loop variable from the factory create, and then we create the new launcher. Yeah. Maybe I will try to Mac OS, but if there is anyone who use Ubuntu can also follow the step, because it's not different from Ubuntu and Mac OS. Yeah, I will try. The CD PHP desktop mkdir. From instant use, I will try to clone my repository. We have folder with just one file, dialog.php, which is have some code. In the first, we include or use the library, and then we require the vendor or composer, and then we create, and we set the entry dialog, and then we can launch the another dialog. Maybe the result will be showed like this. I just forgot the composer install. Okay. Yeah, something like that. What's your name? John. Okay. Yeah, John here is delivered by variable from this kind of like Pasua from the the first dialogue and then pass it to the second dialogue. No name given. Yeah, maybe you can try it.
Only the get 10 user is there. That is how it is coming in here, is it?
Yeah.
No, there is no
the name. Maybe we can try to use launcher. Okay. Yeah, maybe we can try to comment it. Yeah, maybe we don't need the.
Okay, so yeah. Queue basically gets the
yeah,
result, is it?
The queue variable is contain the text we input before. So we can just pass the variable from here, maybe this response like that, this response. Yeah, text. Maybe we can delete it. John, and yeah, maybe we can use a method like the Pasua before. Yeah, maybe we can print it so we can view the variable from the queue. So John, yeah, this should the variable will be passed to the second one.
Actually, like this was the that printed before even we filled up the form.
Yeah.
So I think we have to var export after this. Put a var export after showing the dialog. So if you run it again,
yeah,
you can see that this comes out even before you fill that. Form.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe.
So you just execute again. Don't fill it. Yeah, you see, you go back there. Don't do anything. Yeah, you see, it's already printed.
Yeah.
In the other example, only when you said okay or something, then it printed.
Oh.
You stop the execution there.
Yeah, maybe this can be.
You do it later.
In here, yeah. For export queue, then function. This the entry dialog is by default if okay, he will execute the first block.
There, right?
Yeah. So okay.
This library doesn't seem to stop the execution. It is using some event handler kind of syntax to call that later. So the loop.run keeps checking for this again and again.
Yeah.
If there is a response, then it is processing. Otherwise, it's not doing anything. It will keep on trying one more time. Is there any input?
Yeah, this will print in the CLI. Maybe we can, so we can view the so we can use the response from Q to use in the next dialogue.
Okay, Q didn't print, is it?
Q?
Var export of Q.
No.
The Q, this will be John. Yeah, the one, the first one is from Q, the second one is from John.
The response is printing.
Yeah.
It's a string.
Yeah, maybe it not as flexible as Pashua because we must follow the rules from Zenity, such as function entry dialog, info dialog, warning dialog, and something else. So, but the Zenity is more friendly with cross-platform. Maybe the Linux or Windows can be adapted, and Mac OS can be used it to create the desktop GUI application. Yeah, but the library is still not flexible as the Pashua. Okay. Any question?
Just the
pen
point, it's not HTML.
Yeah.
But yes, you can use wherever
page
we can do. Do you want
to
call API, connect to
MySQL? Yeah, well, we can actually we can still connect to databases since the file is very flat.
PHP.
Yeah, still PHP and
if you use Electron, you cannot do in API calls or connect to database.
You can do all that. It's
Electron.
A different language, different way of doing it.
Okay.
Yeah, maybe we can still, maybe in the middle of the application, we can have connection to databases. It's possible. Mm-hmm. But because my...
And the positioning, the XY is also...
The
leaf of the object. That one is
quite because it's not as CSS. In the CSS we can styling it very easy, but for example in Pashua we must set the coordinates x and y height. Yeah, maybe someone create the CSS for this maybe to easy the interfacing or styling. Yeah, maybe it's very useful, but as far as I know the desktop application should always like this, right? Maybe in the Pascal or
agree. Desktop is desktop. Maybe this one is just for cache.
Yeah.
Do you see things? And do you see there's a need for CSS? This is one to input.
Yeah, the most.
The item.
I was just reading about Zenity and all. It looks like it's a command line tool, kind of like you call the command, pass hyphen option, it will give you some output. So basically, it takes input from the command line and gives output in the command line, kind of. That's how it works. So all these things we are doing is just wrapping that somehow and making it work.
Maybe Zenity, min calendar.
If you go to the genome.org, they have examples of how you can make it work with the shell script. So basically, you call Zenity and then pass --, calendar. It will present a calendar UI. Okay. Whatever date they select, then that is the thing that you will get as the output in the command line.
But we just use the PHP language to wrap it, so the GUI component is very more interactive because we use the PHP.
Yeah. I'm not denying anything that we do with PHP. I'm saying it is possible to do it other ways also. Like if you invest time in Zenity, there are other ways also to make use of it.
Yeah, that's right.
So in the command line interface, you want to ask somebody what is your date of birth, and you don't want to get it as a text input. You want to present a calendar where they select. You can use Zenity to present that calendar component. So they pick the date, then that will be automatically filled in the command line. You can take that input and process further.
Okay. Yeah, I think it's more flexible in Pashua rather than in Zenity, but Zenity is more friendly to cross-platform. Okay. Yeah. This small example, just little example. The rest of function Zenity or Pashua, you can always do it by yourself. This Pashua is very you can explore it more deep. And in PHP Zenity React, we can have in it repositories they have some
function, right?
Yeah,
so it's basically calling a command line thing to do.
Yeah, maybe we can have something like that. We can execute the query or something else. We can mixing the synchronous and asynchronous PHP. And yeah.
But the problem is all the script is on the client side.
Yeah. That is one of the disadvantages. So it does not compile code.
Yes.
They can read it as plain text if they know how to read it.
They can change it.
Yeah. So that's why PHP is better on the server side.
Yeah.
The server, they cannot read it at all.
Yeah.
They can only see the output.
Yeah, this.
If it's a compiled language, it's completely different. You finally get a binary that cannot be read that easily.
Okay, Zenity is finished. Yeah, so. Actually, we create desktop GUI component with PHP is not so hard, but we still look for the best way for make the desktop GUI, because the option is very like the first, yeah, maybe the 7 tools still your choice or your option for create the desktop apps. I just covered how to create desktop apps with Pasua and Zenity, because I think the Zenity and Pasua more friendly to create because it has native GUI component, and yeah, the PHP binding from Zenity is available in the composer. The another one like GTK, VX or Nitron is very hard to compile because very complex, and it wrap the PHP app or the web app. Yeah, the next, how we can bundling it into clickable app, so we don't need to type it in the CLI, but we can just double click, we can bundling it into the one single application, and we just click to run it. Yeah, in the Mac OS we have Platypus. Platypus is bundler for shell script, so we can bundle my, because our script is available from the shell, we can bundling it with Platypus. Maybe we can download it, but Pasua actually have way how it can be bundled into the .app. But if you want to instant bundle, we just only need the Platypus. Maybe I can demo it for you. Yeah, if we open the Platypus, yeah, we can set the application name. Maybe we have example Pasua, and then we have to set the script type to PHP because we need to know where is the PHP binary located, and then we just select the script, maybe the script that we create before, this Pasua example index.php. yeah, so we just interface none and then create app. This will be create in the specific folders, and then we have Pasua example.app application. If we double click it, no. Maybe there is some error. Maybe interface, maybe the text window. Oh yeah, the bundle file is needed by Pasua. We can add it into the Platypus. Because we still need the Pasua.php to create the app. Maybe we can do it and run it again. Example Pasua. Yeah, this the newest one. Okay. Okay, this should be not a pair. Yuri, okay. This something like the CLI.
So whatever we printed on the command.
Yeah, but if we want to don't want to view the CLI, we can select the none, and we create again with index.app. Index.app will be okay. Just simple like this. But until now, I still not find how to bundle the Zenity. Maybe we can try to bundling the Zenity with Platypus. Maybe select script PHP Zenity example. Because it has vendor, yeah, maybe we can include the vendor into Platypus. App name Zenity, maybe none Zenity app. I think it not work with Zenity since it not work with Zenity, but it works well with Pasua. Yeah. Yeah, the second one is we using default option from Pasua. The default option is not very difficult to follow. Just about six step to follow, and you have your first .app. Or desktop application, desktop GUI component with PHP language. The another example, another tools. Maybe you can try the another tools like PHP GTK. It's not problem. Maybe you can compare it to Zenity or Pasua. Yeah. Okay, maybe any question? I think anyone understand? Yeah. I hope you understand and start to play with desktop application with PHP, or maybe you can create the application that useful. Maybe if we have some frameworks or some libraries which is based on PHP and it needs to console via GUI, maybe this can be option because I don't recommend if you have full web app with it graphic at HTML and CSS to be wrapped in the GUI application. But if you have to play with it components, it's no problem. PHP language is only for for manipulate or for we use if else or loop. Maybe the Pasua is have I will try to give the last example for Pasua. I try to create the option for loop from PHP looping. Maybe we start from this. Maybe we just delete it. Mungkin maybe name option. Now maybe we can have combo box. Yeah, combo box is have structure like this. Who is your favorite artist? Yeah, from text, okay. Sanity, we close it. Okay, nah, we try to make some looping for our option. Maybe we try to, yeah, this example for combo box for Pasua, we can generate it like always for web app, but in the desktop app we can loop it. Maybe this we can have option array. Maybe the last one John, the second one is Lorem, the third one is Ipsum. Yeah, like always we can have separate the option, and then we can for each the option array as name or person. And then we can try to text CP option person.
And you need a new line.
Yeah. CP option, okay. Oh,
that's why I told you you need a new line.
Default.
You just put a new line there after the person.
Oh yeah.
Dot PHP OL or.
Yeah, like this.
If you don't put that, it won't work.
Semicolon.
Yeah. Maybe not. Oh yeah. No. Yeah. John, Lorem, Ipsum, because this default commit. Maybe we can delete it. Yeah, we can use the loop control from PHP to our still manual way, but it works. Yeah. And it's still PHP language, right? Yeah. Okay. Okay, maybe any question? Overall, I think we can create the desktop GUI from PHP, but for some purpose only, but not for all purpose. For example, if we want to wrap the full admin dashboard PHP application is not recommendation, but I think if we play with the GUI component that control with PHP language is very interesting and very possible. Okay, any question? Yeah, okay.
Thank you very much, Yuri, for your presentation.